Hi, hello dear friends. Welcome back once again to our channel, Vagai Academy of Mathematics. And this playlist is where you can find video lessons for CAT, MAT and other management exams. This session, again, we have a problem from the concept of ratio and proportion. Let's directly get into the problem. Yes, our question here is, the mass of a circular disc varies as the square of its radius when its thickness is kept a constant. And also, it varies as its thickness when the radius is kept constant. So clearly, here this question is based on the concept of variation, right? Okay. So let us clearly note down what are all the things which are given in the question. So that is, there is a circular disc and about its mass is what? They are telling few informations. Let's clearly note what are all the things given. So the mass of a circular disc. So mass, I'm going to represent it as M, okay? So M is going to vary as what? The square of the radius. This is what they have given. Okay. The square of the radius. So square of the radius in the sense R square. We'll write it as R square. I'm going to notate radius as R. And when the thickness is kept constant. And also it varies as. Which one is going to vary as? The same mass. Okay. Same mass is going to vary as thickness when the radius is kept constant. So the same M is again proportional to the thickness of the disc. Okay, I'm going to represent thickness as T. Okay, let me use different variables for all these different things, the quantities. So M is going to stand for mass, R for radius and T for thickness. So far we have got two informations. One is mass is proportional to radius square and mass is proportional to thickness. This is what we have. Fine, yes. Now again, continue the question. Now find the ratio of the radii of two discs. So that means there are two discs whose thickness are in the ratio 16:3 and the mass of the first one is thrice the second. So that means now they are raising up a question comparing two discs. Okay. And about the two discs, what they have given? They have again given two informations. Let us again clearly note those informations also. Okay. So what is it they have given? There are two discs and their thickness are in the ratio 16:3. So let me notate the thickness of the two discs to be T1 and T2. So that means I can very well write it as T1:T2. This ratio is what is equal to what? This is what is equal to 16:3. Am I right? Okay. Yeah, fine. This is one part. And again, and the mass of the first one is thrice the second. So they are comparing the mass of the two discs also. Okay, that is also compared. So let me do again one more thing. I'm going to represent the mass of the two discs to be M1 and M2. Corresponding, I'm taking mass of the first disc M1, mass of second disc M2. This also they are making a comparison. And how are they comparing it? The mass of the first one is thrice the second. So that means if the second one's mass is like one part, the first one mass will be like 3 parts. So 3:1. So again, I can represent using a ratio, right? So M1:M2 is equal to 3:1. If that is so, and what we are supposed to find? Find the ratio of their radii. This is what we are supposed to find of the two discs. Okay. So that means we are supposed to find the ratio of their radii. That is R1:R2 is what? This is what we are supposed to find. I hope the question is clear to you. So you have got so many informations here. One is mass and mass they are comparing with respect to radius and the thickness. And how are they comparing? Here this side mass is proportional to R square. And this side mass is proportional to thickness. And these two informations are given. Finally asked, what is this? This is all about this question. And let us now get some approach how we can solve this problem. Okay, all right. Yeah, fine. Now we will begin from this pieces itself. Fine. So anyways, they are comparing mass only, right? So mass is proportional to R square. Mass is proportional to thickness. So let's do a thing here. Let us just put these two pieces together. All right. Okay. So if we try to do it, so we'll get mass is directly proportional to R square times T. We can do it, right? Yes. Because anyways, individually they are proportional. So that when we put them together also, that will again be proportional. Okay. Fine. Yes. With some proportionality constant. So mass is proportional to R square into T. So that what we can write is mass divided by r square into t will be equal to some constant. We can arrive to this condition. Or in other words, how we can say is m1 by r1 square t1 will be same as m2 by r2 square t2. You may wonder why we are doing this. It's going to be a very simple fact. Since this m by r square into t is always equal to constant, always whatever values they take, that will be equal to the other values also, whatever values they take in the second case also. And that is the reason I'm equating like this. And at the same time, here, see here, we have got comparing two disks, is it or not? So that means every measure we have two twos. And also this will also help us to use this relation in getting the answer. That is the reason we are arriving to such a conclusion. All right, okay. Now, all we need to do is just use these ratio terms, ratio things which are given here. We will just use it here. We solve it. We can easily get what is R1 is to R2. Yes, we'll proceed now. So I'm going to take this M1 and M2. Very simple. Anyways, we have got M1 is to M2 is equal to 3 is to 1, right? We can use the same values here. That is, we can replace this M1 as 3. So 3 by, what about this R1 square? R1 square, we have no idea. Of course, they are asking about R1 is to R2 only in this question itself. Next to T1, in the place of T1, we can directly take the value 16, no issues. Okay, so R1 square, I'm writing it as it is, into 16. So this will be same as, now coming to the right hand side, now this is about the second disk. So M2, M2 will be actually, this is equivalent to 1. We can take it as 1 itself. So 1 by R2 square. So R2 square, I'm writing as it is, into, what about T2 here? T2 value is 3. We can take the ratio terms itself. It is equal to 3. Fine. Okay. Yes. Now we will just try to bring R1, R2 squares to one side and all the numbers to the other side. Shall we do that? So if we try to do so, what happens is I can just bring this by 3 to this side. So this 3 will be coming to this numerator position. So this will become 3 threes are by this 16 will stay here in the same side, and this side, right hand side, will become this R1 square will go to this numerator position, so that we get R1 square by this R2 square will stay there itself, R2 square. Fine. Yes. Okay. Again, I'm continuing it. So I'm just going to write the LHS in the right hand, left hand side. I'm going to take it on the right hand side, I'm going to take it on the left hand side. I'm just going to interchange their positions. So now I will have R1 square by R2 square, which will be equal to, now come to this numerator, this is 3 threes are 9 by 16. This is what we are getting. Now very simple, I'm going to continue it here this space. So I will be getting R1 square by R2 square equal to 9 by 16. So when we take square roots on both the sides, we will clearly get R1 by R2 is equal to, what about right hand side? Right hand side, we will have this 9 to be 3 square. So that when we get a root of 9, we'll have 3 divided by denominator 16. We got root 16, that will become 4. So that's it. We are getting R1 by R2 is equal to 3 by 4. Now it is going to be very simple. If this fraction is equal to this fraction, so that means ratio will also be equivalent. R1 is to R2 will also be equivalent to 3 is to 4. Finished. This will give the answer. Fine. Yes. So though this question appears to be so much informative, lengthier, the way of solving it will be very easier only. If we get some smart approach now, we can very easily solve this question. So we have to collect the pieces and put them, organize them, and then we try to solve it. It is going to be a very, very easy process. Fine. Okay. Yes. I hope the approach we handled to solve this problem is very clear to you. And if at all any doubts also you are getting, please kindly post it in the comment box. I will see it. I'll see to rectify your doubts. And if you like this session, please give a like for this video. And also, if you feel that this session is going to be useful for any of your friends who are preparing for any of these kind of management exams, please do share this video to your friends also. And again, in our next session, we'll catch up soon with some other interesting problem. See you soon there. Thank you so much.